motion that we skip on permit.
That we table it.
Table until next meeting, March, to March.
Second.
Any discussion? We have a second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Did everybody have a chance to look at Corey's minutes that he sent out for December 6th?
Motion may be made. They've accepted and submitted.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Are there any changes to the amended minutes that were sent back out after the last meeting from the 29th?
Motion to accept.
Thank you.
Second.
You can ask if you can make any amendments after.
Any discussion?
Right, I thought we accepted with the...
With the amendment.
With the amendment, so they're already accepted.
Yep. But I don't know that we... Any hesitation on this whole question?
All right, first, I would like to apologize for not being able to project. I think with the snow day and professional development today, with the water in the building today, here in the building, some of our communications got crossed paths. So I love to project. I work on a PowerPoint. I really wanted this to be the first one that you all saw it, but I am going to have a short presentation first. I think you all know who Dr. Brown, who is the SAU support here tonight as we go forward. So I'm just going to very quickly go through what would have been a delightful PowerPoint presentation. And I also apologize for the Wi-Fi. The password needed to be set yesterday. It reset yesterday. The old one stopped working yesterday, and no one has been in since then to reset it, so we have no access to Wi-Fi. And I apologize for that, too, because I know some of you have electronic copies of the budget. All right, so we are here tonight. I'm here tonight to present to the Budget Committee the Rollinsford School District budget for 2018-2019, so the next school year. For those of you that have the pictures, there's the, we'll come back to that chart on that part. I'll just keep going. So the good news overall is that the Rollinsford School District budget is down. It's down just over $75,000, but just under $75,000. Thanks to the RGS, that's this building's specific budget, which is down by over $90,000. So the overall budget is down. And over the past 4 years, as all of you have heard me say over and over again, the board and the administration have worked. They've been committed, we've scoured the proposed budgets for accuracy and looking for savings. This budget marks the fourth year in a row that the RGS portion of the budget has been reduced, has reduced its cost year over year, and that's really good news. And also, as we've noted each year, we've taken those savings pretty much and reinvested them back into the building in the form of warrant articles. Unfortunately, the state giveth and the state taketh away. And so using its own formulas is sometimes making it very difficult to predict. This year, the revenues are down. So overall, the net result is that we will have to raise more by taxation this year than we did last year due to the state revenues being down. If you have your budgets and you want to sort of follow along, I'm going to just very briefly now talk about a slide. So I'm just going to go sort of on the major lines. So this is now going to be regular education I'm talking about. It's line 1100.
Regular
the whole budget put together, because I'm going to do RGS, Marshwood, and the Marshwood schools as we go forward. It's unfortunate, you know, again, the picture would have been nice, and I do apologize again for that, but that's sometimes how it goes. For all of you who are into astrology, I'm sure it means Mercury is retrograde, but we're just going to let that go. So, in regular education, that's district-wide, regular education. We have an increase in the RGS budget over last year, primarily due to health premiums and the technology that we've been working on. Here at RGS, we've tightened the regular education budget over the past few years, and we're running pretty lean. And the technology part of the budget is we're in like the second or third year of a five-year technology plan that we're following to keep our technology up to date as we move forward. In Marshall Middle School, we have a decrease over last year, due primarily to the actual number of students attending. And I do want to make a note, in case you didn't notice it, that we have two contingency students for middle school or high school, and we've plugged them into the middle school now. And that's, you'll remember the first year when we had 15 students come in that we hadn't planned on, so in working with you guys last year, we decided to put a few contingency students in each year. In Marshwood High School, it has increased over last year due primarily to the actual number of students attending. And next school year, FY19, will be the first year that all roles for 9 through 12 students will be enrolled at Marshwood. We will have no regular students enrolled in Summersworth, starting with the next school year. And of note this year, I was happy to see this, the Marshwood regular tuition remains almost constant. I think it's pennies. It's pennies difference over the tuition rate from our current year. That was good news to see. Right, I'm now moving on to sort of an overview of lines 1210 through 2120, essentially special education, English as a second language, and guidance. So at RGS, that has increased over last year due primarily to the need of an additional mainstream coach. And by the way, a mainstream coach means it's a special education need. So we needed an additional mainstream coach. We do have savings in the English as a second language line. And that's due to actually needing anyone for that. At Marshwood Middle School, we have a small increase over last year due primarily to increase in services. The actual number of students receiving services has decreased. And that line, as I'm sure you noticed when you look through, also includes teacher and guidance services that we provide here out of Boston Grade School that help oversee some of the students at Marshwood Middle School. And the same is true at Marshwood High School. We had special ed has increased over last year due primarily to the actual number of students receiving services and an increase in services.
Can you say that one more time, Judy? Did you say the high school increase?
Yes. The special education.
High school special education.
Yes.
Not just high school.
High school special education.
So on page 3, that tuition at the high school is a decrease. Is that not? Am I on the wrong page? Very
well. Yeah, I know. And I could be.
Summersworth High School has increased.
Yeah, you need to go to page 4 and look at the. I'm sorry. I'm looking at the totals. We asked because while there was a decrease, we also had an out of. We know we'll have an out of district placement. And so overall, the entire budget has increased.
On page 4 of this narrative, you're talking about tuition to a private school, high school and middle school.
Yes.
Okay.
So I guess technically it's probably not a Marshwood High School increase. It's a special special education at the high school level that has increased. It's not really Marshwood.
Right, because it does say that the high school.
I think that's probably a better way to put it. Yeah, that was my. Yeah. It's just, you know, it is bad.
Thank you.
So you're saying this, which is your proposed budget, compensates for that reduction?
That is correct. Unfortunately, that's great. It looks like a big jump because we were not able to,
Does that approximately equal?
No, it goes up more. It goes up more than what we have. This budget, the budget that before us for fiscal year 19, is we did not receive enough this year to cover what our costs are for that year. That's what you're asking. That's correct. It does not. Yes.
So the actual operation of the SAU, I realize that they've been able to use the funding of some of the funding for it from fund balance, but has the have the expenses gone through? Is that question clear?
Yes. Yes, it is. I'm going to look for a little bit of help here. So expenses at the SAU.
Portion of the total administrative cost in Summersworth and Rossford is actually assessed to Robinson.
About 15%.
15%?
Between 15 and 16%. It's a state formula, and it's based on our K-6 enrollment.
And that really, whether the students are going to Marshwood or going here or Summersworth,
It makes no difference. The SAU oversees all of our students K through 12, but we are assessed on our Rollinsford grade school students.
Our three student numbers is what drives
yes.
The proportion.
That's correct. Getting a dollar. Any other question? I know this is difficult. It looks like a big jump. Because we've been offsetting it, and now we're picking up the full amount. So that's one of the reasons it looks like a big jump there. So school administration, 2400, and property liability. For Rawlinsford Grade School Administration, we have a decrease over last year. Primarily to benefit changes that offset increases in the health and dental premiums. There's a proposed 2% salary increase. And I just want to make a note that you may have noticed this as you look through the budget, but we have adjusted this year's line, this year's column, to reflect the accurate principal salary for this year. So that you can then see the 2% increase that we're proposing for her. Property liability insurance has decreased a bit, which is nice. It's always nice to have insurance rates go down. Nothing there applicable to Marshall students. Now 2621, 2622, custodial services and utilities. So the custodial services, it's increased. Due primarily to the addition of the proposed addition of one part-time custodian for 8 hours a week during the school year, and one part-time custodian 20 hours a week during the summer. There's also an increase in health and dental premiums and a proposed 2% salary increase. So So the rationale for adding a part-time custodian, it's a process, and so it's a story. We can sit around the campfire and talk about what we're doing with custodians. We reduced custodial staff a couple years ago, as I think you'll remember. And most recently that morphed into one full-time and one very part-time person. That's currently what we have. And it's been a struggle to maintain the building with the staffing, especially during the summer months. We've taken on more and more in-house work. We do a lot more painting. We do a lot more deep cleaning. We've taken on in-house the lawn and grounds maintenance. That's no longer, we don't no longer hire anyone to do that. And because they're so busy during the summer, they don't have time to take vacation and time off that they're entitled to, and they end up taking it grounds when school's in session. It's just not done in a timely manner. So it's a process, and we're trying to figure out how to we managed to right-size our teaching staff, we believe, at this point, but we're still figuring out how to right-size our custodial staff. And we'll talk more about that a little bit later on, too. For utilities, we have a decrease, primarily due to savings in the electrical usage. And I would say that's directly attributed to the work our facilities director and custodial staff have been doing. They really stay on top of the LED lighting. They're vigilant about shutting off, going around making sure all the electrical use is proper. And of course, let's not forget the wonderful community-supported three-phase power that we now have here in the building. That's good. So that's good. Moving on, line 2630 maintenance and 2640 equipment maintenance. So there's a large decrease in that line, and that's due primarily to the way the 2018 warrant articles we voted on this last March, are accounted for in the budget. For a reality check, I mean, the biggest ticket item under these maintenance items is the need to replace the bell and phone system. And that was actually something called out in the IDEA study that was done 5 years ago, that needed to be done. And it needed to be done in this actually before this time frame. It was one of the first things that they said needed to be done. So that's sort of one of the big ticket items that's there right now. A couple of the other items you will see there, the board has discussed addressing safe and secure doors. If we have the money and we know we're getting a little extra money, saving money on the SAP line, and so we're hoping to address the safe and secure doors this year. We're hoping to do that. And we've also talked about addressing cupola repair this year. Yes, we've done a lot of talking about the grant money. There is grant money available. It has to be matched. It takes a lot of time and effort to go after that grant money. That's good to know. Right, that's good to know. Thank you, Dennis. It's good to know. It may or may not be worth looking into. We'll have to find out what. It's certainly worth discussing, and the board actually had quite a long discussion about it at one of our budget workshops.
I was just going to point out from my own experience of being an agent here that the grant very terms and conditions, sometimes those terms and conditions are cause you to spend more money than you might otherwise think. So it really depends on what those terms and conditions are, how much you have to match, whether you can only do it. And I don't know any of this, but if you pay the people in a certain way and it's an expensive way, it doesn't allow you to. So you almost have to balance out what those situations.
And that's what I meant by my answer as well. In our discussion at our board meeting, we had a long discussion. It was about if we repair it to historical standards, it's going to cost $100,000. If we put it back together so it's neat, painted, pieces aren't falling off, we currently have a quote for $5,000. That's a huge difference. And a huge difference in time. We can address the first one immediately. The other one, we would have to wait a year or a year and a half for the grant. So these are the things we're weighing as we look at it. There's no change in the equipment maintenance. Right. Transportation. Really, very, very small changes, a slight increase. We have a five-year transportation contract. It goes up every year by 5% or so yearly, something like that. So that's there. There's no change in our special education transportation. And there's a small increase to the after-school activity bus that we run from Marshwood. Marshwood provides the bus. We pay Marshwood by the mile for them to deliver our kids to Rollinsford, the one place in Rollinsford. There's a slight increase in that. Other benefits as support services. There's a decrease due primarily to staff tuition and workshop savings. We have a principal who is able to run workshops. We have other staff here who are able to run workshops, so we don't have to hire as many people to run them. And that's a good thing. So and they often do workshops in other places. But anyway, there's a decrease in that line, which is nice. So as you, this would have been a really nice slide to see, but it's not as fun just to talk about it. But essentially, though, the RGS portion of the budget, if you're looking in this book, the first part of it, it also includes transportation and SAU costs, is just over $3 million. And that's a decrease from this current year's budget of over $90,000. So the budget, RGS budget has gone down. The Marshwood budget for both middle and high school is a total of about $2.5 million.
I'm confused on the, you said the grade school's gone down, but you have no warrants in this proposal right now. And we
right, this is the operating budget. That's correct. This is the operating budget.
And we had $125,000 last year in the two warrant articles. So if you took that out of the school, the budget in Rollinsford grade school is going up. Am I wrong?
No, and this, I will say, I've been doing these budgets for 5 years now. The most confusing thing is how warrants are accounted for, because they do get put into the budget, you're correct. And they are
included. They went to Rollinsford grade school for last year. And if you take that out, this year's budget is going up in the Rollinsford grade school.
I don't understand. It would go down by that much more. I'm a little confused by that. But
you had $125,000 in warrants. If you took that out of last year's budget, and you say you're only saving $73,000 this year, how do you think you're saving money? Do you have any warrants going in this year?
We'll get to that in a minute.
Can I clarify? He's talking about total budget versus operating budget.
Right.
And there is $125,000 more. The difference there. Okay, the blank book.
I am talking about the operating budget without warrants at the moment. For what is proposed for,
and that's what's in this, is just operating.
This is just the operating budget. There are no warrant articles included in the operating budget.
All right.
Thank you
for bringing that. In this current year's budget, as you saw in the 2600 line, you started with one warrant article, let's add $5 million, and then you had two additional warrant articles that totaled $125,000 that get added into the budget. That's what you're talking about, correct?
Yep.
So because that was added into the current year, We already appropriated that money, and that money was spent. So as he indicated, then that money automatically comes out, and that's indicated and stated in the narrative in the 2600 line.
help compare last year and this year's budget?
It was. It was taken out, but then as you see listed below that, there's also other projects that are reducing that savings.
Yep.
Because there's all the lighting, the development, the pipe installation, that's eating up some of that savings.
For clarity, because now I thought I knew and now I'm confused. Is the one, we're looking at the negative 113 on that?
110?
110.
Okay.
Do you have
version 2, version 3?
Of the negative 110.
Oh, 113, I see.
So of the negative 110, we need to add back in.
Well,
the 125, so we end up with an increase of 15,000-ish?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, because I think that's what Charlie
was getting at.
Okay.
I'm back.
Yes, thank you, Michelle.
I do find the way warrants are included and not included, you know, whether here and there, are very confusing. To me, that's one of the most confusing parts. So I think we're ready.
Clarification. Of the 90,000 that's being saved at the grade school, 50,000 is money which is not putting into savings anymore. For special ed building.
What the town enters into the Department of Revenue Administration.
So it reflects what the, how the board takes the bottom line and distributes it across those categories, because that's what the board can do. And so that's, that becomes our, the budget that we are then working with.
Well, I just think it's probably confusing voters to look at the latest data, annual report, the proposed budget on your website, and see a different number than what you're proposing this year.
Yeah, I think, and I understand what you're saying, and certainly the voters that look line by line will be happy to answer questions. What's important is that the bottom line remains the same, because as Suzanne was saying, the school board has line item authority, and so as long as we don't change the bottom line in any way, we can move money around in any of the lines that we want. We try to leave it in the lines and see as much as we can. Like, we're going to leave the SAU line this year. We're not going to move it to another line. We're going to leave it and show that it has that we have a savings in essence in that line.
I think it would be more useful for people to see actuals than so the numbers can be resolved.
Well, we don't have an actual yet. We haven't finished this year. It's not. We don't have an actual budget this year until we close the books sometime in September or October of next year. So that's why you see the actuals for FY16 and FY17, because those books have been closed.
Yeah.
And otherwise, and now because of the timing of things, we have a budget in flux. Can't go over the bottom line. That's the law. But we can move things around inside if we have to.
So the bottom line 2018 that's in the annual report says $5,555,156. But the adopted 2018 says $5,730,656.
The warrant articles
are added. So if you take the 555, you take the $5,555, you add the $50,000 for the two warrants, for
yep.
the two trust funds.
Okay.
Then you add the $125,000, and it should come out to exactly the $5,736,056.
Okay.
You start off with warrant article number five.
Mm-hmm.
That's what people voted for, the operating budget. And then each additional warrant article that was passed gets incorporated. So if you take the 555 and you add those three warrant articles, you're going to come out with that number that was adopted.
Okay.
And that's why the annual report is different than what was adopted.
Well, I understand. I was going to say, what we're talking about here right now is an operating budget, which is one of the warrant articles.
Yes. Right, correct.
And there's the other warrant articles, and so for me, I don't really see the whole picture until I know what all the warrant articles
right.
are, and I see them all together.
Correct.
Because you may be taking money out of a bond issue, or you may be getting a gift, and so forth. So we really don't know the impact on the budget until we know how you're going to finance each article. This one is all going to be financed, as I understand it, bottom line here, by the taxpayers.
That is correct.
And that's why it's the most important to us, because it's the main one. But to really fully understand the budget, we've got to see how all these X number of warrant articles presented to us. And then you can see how you're going to finance each one. And then we'll see what worries Ed is what's the bottom line to my taxes next year.
Understood. All right. At any rate, the bottom line, once again, sort of what we started out with, is that due to, my next slide, which you'll be all happy to see, talks about anticipated revenues. And again, we don't have a lot of ways we don't have much revenue in terms of the school budget. We have what the state provides us with, and we have what we raise by taxation. And the state has reduced this year what they are giving us for next year. And therefore, unfortunately, even though our operating budget is down, we will have to raise more by taxation, unfortunately, due to decreased revenues to cover this operating budget. So that's the bottom line. What are the warrants that are under consideration? We have not, the board has not made final decisions on warrants, but a probable warrant is going to be the annexing kindergarten roof. And I went back and looked at the IPEA study that was done again, whatever it was, five or six years ago. And so a probable warrant will be a warrant for the annex and kindergarten roof. The annex was due to be replaced in 2012 and the kindergarten in 2018 based on the IBEA study. So it's timely. It's the seams were supposed to, again in the IBEA study, the seams were supposed to have been addressed. It's a flat roof. The seams are, I know it keeps our facilities director awake at night, knowing that if that seam goes, we lose a lot of, we lose space, we lose time, we lose equipment, we lose all sorts of things. So that's a probable warrant. We are still in active negotiations with the union, so we do not have a collective bargaining agreement to discuss this evening.
Okay, on the roof, have you got an estimate on that?
We do. It's just under $100,000. The warrant article would probably be for $100,000. We had asked, the board had asked the facilities director through the principal to get, to make sure that he has a certain number of estimates.
Was that a recent?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it was recent.
I have other questions.
All right, so again, we don't have a collective bargaining agreement to discuss yet. We're still in active negotiations. I think it would be prudent, so I'm guessing that we will put forward putting money into the building reserve fund because we can use it as a capital improvement fund. And so, our current balance in that is just over $103,000. We have some very big ticket items coming down the road. Boiler replacement eventually, a number of other things. Roof on the main building in a number of years. I think we could get out ahead of that by building up a capital reserve fund for that. We can talk about whether or not it's prudent to create more reserve funds. And that's why the board hasn't heard this yet. We're going to talk about it tomorrow night. But we could have a reserve fund for tuition, for instance, rather than putting in contingency students. We could do that. But we'll have that discussion tomorrow, and we'll keep you informed as to whether or not we think we want to go forward with that.
Back to the collective bargaining. Isn't there a time limit for that? Was that December 1st?
No. It falls in January. It has to be so many weeks before the public.
It's the last day for the collective bargaining agreement would be January 9th. The second, same thing as any particular. It's the same date as petition warrant.
Are we going to have a meeting with the budget committee to review that? That's a dollar item.
It's a dollar item, yeah. You're
going
to have to,
I'm thinking through my head about the schedule.
Don't we have one scheduled for January?
I think that's a workshop.
Right, we'll
have to expand that in the warrant articles.
It's going to be time for all of us, absolutely.
Sorry, I was looking at some numbers. Did you say you are going to do the one article for building reserve this year?
Probably, yes.
So that wouldn't negate what you have here? You reduced it by the two warrant articles, 50,000. Well, he's here. So one of the reductions is $50,000 for the building improvement fund, but you're going to put in the warrant. So it's really only a $25,000.
I'm very confused. I don't know what you're asking, John. I'm sorry.
So, in the RGS budget, the RGS total budget, $50,000 was reduced via warrant articles.
Yes, and that put $25,000 into the special education reserve fund and $25,000 into the, and that happened this year. And that's not for next year. That happened this year. That was the two $25,000 items that we warrant articles that we voted on in March.
So, so that brought our total reduction to $90,000, right? With those two warrant articles,
right?
Being removed from the budget.
Yes, and once again, I will tell you, warrant articles and the way they're moved in confuse me entirely. So,
so really, that $90,000 is going to be reduced by $25,000 because you're going to put in for a warrant article for the building.
Well, now, those warrant articles are, if there is money left in our budget that we have not spent, then it will go in. And as a board, we have started talking about it being more than $25,000 because we have to build that up. We have to put a new boiler in and do some other things. We have $200,000-$300,000 things coming down the pipe. So
just for clarification, so we're potentially not saving $90,000.
No, because that you're confusing budgets now. I think you're confusing the budgets, but
Marie is waving.
So I guess you have to think of different buckets, okay? And each warrant article is a bucket. So what was being presented here is warrant article number 5, which is the operating budget. That's bucket number 1. So I'm going to say warrant article number 5.
Right.
Then there's going to be and community votes for it. That's the dollar amount that gets voted for. Then there's the potential of negotiation. So let's say the negotiation, I'm going to put a number on there, is $2,000. If the community votes, which I think doesn't have, then that bucket gets added to it.
Right.
If it doesn't get voted, it doesn't get in. Same thing as you're indicating with the building fund. Let's say it's $2,000. They have the board have determined that dollar amount. If the voters vote that down, it doesn't get included in this article. So right now we're only talking about the operating budget. And what Judy's indicating is there's going to be other warrant articles that may be presented. But right now we're just talking about operating budget. And those other ones, as you said, may be added, but only if the community votes to include them.
Right. But in the end, the end result may be that it's really only $65,000 that's being saved because community does vote to put $25,000 into the building fund.
She's not talking about net gross budget.
And you're talking now a whole budget ahead of where we are. So again, it does get very confusing. Anything that goes into these special reserve funds is not being raised by taxation. There is no effect on taxation. It is money that if we have it, we put it into reserve. Now there are cases where we can say if we start a new fund, we might decide to go to the voters and say, we want to start this new fund using taxation. I mean, we could do it that way as well. But we're trying not to do that as well. So I will just, so those are the possibilities that are coming. That are coming up. And as, you know, I can't talk specifically about the collective bargaining agreement, but as every single person who has addressed the budget committee already this year, you know, Dennis mentioned it, library folks mentioned it, the police, the fire, it is harder and harder to find good people, to hire good people, to keep good people as we go forward. And it's tough, and you know, we're feeling the pinch along with everybody else. So. But I think that's probably enough of my talk without having any pictures to go along with it. So we'll just open it up to questions and comments.
You ready? No, say no if you're not ready. Okay, so I look at page 1 of 7 of your summary sheet, which everybody has. We don't have this. And it shows your high school enrollment. I'd like to look at that first. And we lost 11 students
how the summers were, i.e. they graduated, not lost. And we gained 11 at Marshwood. That was just cohorts moving up, right? Okay. But there's one student left in Summersworth.
That's correct.
And if you look, if I look, as I look, at the cost for special ed in Summersworth, it's $35,000. And I guess the question centers around, why aren't all the students now at Marshwood? Why are they there? At least one student, very high price, still going to Summersworth.
That is legally mandated. And that's about all we need.
But to stay in Summersworth, that's what I think that's the biggest question.
It is legally mandated
to stay in Summersworth and not close everything out in Summersworth.
It is legally mandated.
You need to have a court order.
It is legally mandated. It's truly all that we can say. It's truly all that we can say.
I just find it hard to believe that Marshwood has done such an excellent job in special ed that many of the students are now out of their IEPs and their mainstream. Why Marshwood wasn't considered?
Also by law, there are different, there are the state of Maine and the state of New Hampshire have different age points.
I thought that was better.
Custodial services salaries. Is there any way to get a breakdown of your salaries in the budget? I would like a breakdown.
You want other payments?
It is.
No, I, it's
in the back.
Is it in the back of what each person makes?
It's in the back, yes. School bus going around the neighborhood that they forgot to register their child for kindergarten. So these things happen. And we see a lot of fluctuation right up through the holidays, right up through New Year's. There's a lot of fluctuation. And yes, if a school district asks for records, then we know where they went.
Right.
Otherwise, we don't.
Wait.
We have no way of knowing.
A 9-year-old disappears, nobody asks for their records to another school. This doesn't raise a red flag somewhere.
So we have all through grade school from 16 to 17. So you have sixth grade, let's say you have 20 kids in sixth grade going to seventh grade.
Yes.
But you may not have that many kids coming into the school. So your enrollment. So you have it at the graduating end, and you have it and then you have people that move in between. So
I understand the whole thing about cohorts, and on average that would be about the same over time. But when kids leave, you need to know where they go.
No, we don't. It is not our responsibility. And I will tell you this.
Okay, so it's not your responsibility. Do you feel a moral obligation or not?
Sure. Let me tell you one of the first questions I asked when I joined the school board. How many homeschool students do we have in Rollinsford? You know something? We don't know. And we are not legally obliged to know. So it is not the school district's job to do that. They do not belong, students do not belong to the school district. They belong to their parents. They're legal guardians.
And they want the interest in this state of affairs, but it probably isn't our budget, certainly not the budget committee's thing.
I understand that,
speak to the school district. Speak to your state rep.
Yeah.
Right?
If you have a highly transitory population of children, that means there's a problem probably with housing stock or economics and transportation.
I don't disagree. We're the budget committee.
Yes.
We're not going to solve society's
problem.
So, you know, we need to find a proper venue, I think, to explore that. I mean, and I applaud you're bringing it up. I think it's a good thing to think about and consider. But we're not going to solve that.
Okay, if last year we had 164 students, this year we got 154, that's 10. That's subject to, do you ever think of reducing staff?
Yeah, we do feel that we're pretty right-sized in staff right now. We're down to 9 classroom teachers. The biggest, we have a bubble moving through the school, and so one of the reasons, ways we have right-sized is to have staff that are very flexible, that go teaching and do other types of models so that we can have teachers be where the largest group of students is. You know, it's not simple math of 154 divided by 9 necessarily. It's where to move around.
How are we doing on test scores?
Test scores, well, you can standardize test scores.
Test.
I actually do not know.
How many tests are we doing from?
We've cut
from 2 to 1, right?
Well, they've been cut. I don't know if it's down to 1 standardized. I don't know. And Principal Lucas is not with us this evening, but we can get that answer.
Has the Department of Education released the per pupil cost and average number of students per teacher? They do it every year. It's December, it's usually released about now.
I do not have.
They just posted it this last week on the New Hampshire Department of Education website. And I looked at it and compared last year's Rossville Grade School first student cost this year, and it's less. The first student cost in the current year is less than last year for the grade school.
Cut it. manipulating numbers, moving dollars into different line items, and they aren't reflective of what the original line item was. It might be more useful going forward to talk about budget formats. Instead of having like 3 years of data, maybe have 2 years of data and have a column that was the original appropriated line item amount. Because I can just go back and forth and see what it was originally and now what you're saying the adopted amount was, which is your adjusted amount for the year. But I would like to know how it was adjusted, how the lines were adjusted. For example, the teacher salary line item, it was 651 and change in the annual report, but it's now 654 in your adopted budget. So there's a difference of $3,000 there somewhere. And that isn't reflected unless you go back and look at the annual report.
I'm just going to come back to what I said earlier, and that is when the budget is voted on, and I'm speaking from town, the budget is voted on at town meeting. For example, money was added to the operating budget. And so, but it is the select board that then provides the adopted, that puts into the DRA, reports to the DRA, what that budget is based on the bottom line. So it wouldn't be the same, that's why it is not the same as what you see in the annual report. It changed.
There are no documents that went out to the public that match what you have in this document for certain line items.
I'm sorry, say that again?
It's not your budget, it's Judy's budget. The annual report and the last proposed budget that you have on your website have line items that don't reflect the year. And I understand it's because you moved money around to different line items.
We only moved money in the administration line. We moved money to the administration line from a couple of other lines. That was in the 2018 budget, yes.
Well, maybe Marie can explain then why the annual report, the number, reflects. So it's line item 10,1100, 5,100, teacher salaries. So the budget, teacher salaries are in education. It's 651,582. In the annual report and in the proposed budget that's on your website as the last proposed budget. But in this document that you shared with us, it's 650.
Now, one of the things that may have happened in that time is that, I know that in the school year, very shortly in, we had to hire a parent. So that could be part of it. I'm assuming that could be part of it. I don't know that for sure. But again, this is the proposed budget was voted on. As long as the bottom line stays the same, whatever happens in those lines is the job of the school board to deal with.
And I understand that, but we should be able to see what the original amount was and what the new amount is. So for 2018 in this document,
well, what you're saying is you want to be able to see it all in one document. You want to see it in the new proposed budget.
Yeah.
We'll take that under advisement.
So there's a difference of about $3,000 between them. And we don't have any idea what that was or why there was an adjustment there.
Well, it could be anything. The staffing has changed. I know that for sure. And then I don't know if that was it or not, but it also could have happened at the end of the year. I don't know. But
one of the things that Suzanne does is she kind of knows when there's a change in the line item. So that might be helpful. But to see, what went out to the public and what the difference is now is what I'm looking for another column. So there, a change column that it was 651 when it went out, it's now 654. The difference is 3,000 and why?
Yeah, we'll take that under advisement. Thank you.
Other questions? Is that it? Seriously, that's it? All right, well, good, good.
Carefully, my challenge is to front my top down or something. Get out while it's good.
Thank you.
So we do have to schedule another one.
Are we done with this one? Are we adjourned?
No, we're not adjourned. But Andy just said it's meeting,
For what purpose?
The warrants.
The warrants.
We have to get to see the warrants before they put in front of the deliberative session.
But when did she say they were going to happen?
When's the deliberative session?
13th of January.
13th of January. And we have a meeting on what, the 10th? We would have to get there. By the 10th place.
Everybody, a document about it.
to be forwarded to the select board.
I'll second it for conversation.
This is just supporting this document and forwarding it to the select.
That's it.
That's the only action we will take.
Okay.
Is there any discussion?
Move question?
Does anybody have questions about it?
I haven't seen it.
Oh, you haven't seen it? Are you on the email yet?
No.
He doesn't.
Oh, okay.
If he wants to scan, take a quick scan as well.
What if, I did not realize he's not on email.
So you can get your.
I'm on email, but my computer.
You can talk to my AOL now.
You know, there's no harm in asking for help.
I don't need help, I need a new,
Email account.
So I'm gonna set up just something I was gonna bring up anyway, and then get a Gmail account for this.
Yeah.
Because every time, I even did a sprint, a print screen approved, they sent it the first time, and I don't print it, and then it doesn't send it again. Like, see, it's the right thing. I don't know what it is, and it will only do it if I do two of the same.
Right.
I know, it makes no sense, I don't understand.
I figured it out now, so that.
We believe you.
It's ridiculous, but I will get a Gmail account for this committee, so that I can get some help.
Dennis, did you get a copy? Also, a child that doesn't get any correspondence in his Gmail account. We're waiting for Ed because he has.
He's never seen the document. He was just looking at it.
Who's in Canada? He gets an email list.
I did put in a request for
it. To whom did you request?
I didn't see that. I believe I mentioned to me, did I go directly to Tier and ask? I think I went directly to Tier and asked Tier. Well, that's it.
Tier is not part of a governing body to make any kinds of those changes. I would suggest that you ask the chair of the budget committee.
It was brought up at the budget meeting that was not on the email, that there was someone else with an AOL account under his name. And I was told
so
that
Charlie,
was
what is your email then?
He doesn't.
She knows about
it. I'll email it to you.
If you look at the town website, the budget committee composition, they're all there.
So then why isn't it? Oh, you were never on that
list? I was on some other forum list.
He was at. It shows up on there, but he never received it.
We mentioned it at the first meeting.
But are you on the list now?
The only way I did it through my wife.
Oh, he's not. Okay. So, if it's not there, where am I?
I'll email it.
Okay, you give it to me and I'll send it to you.
Email it to me.
And you have an email that's just broken.
Hmm?
You have email, but it's broken.
Well, the email works just fine. He doesn't know how to make it work.
You can ignore that, because I ignore it when he sends it.
It's E, just a minute, I can give it to you.
But do you?
Huh?
You see, if you send it to EFJJ@comcast.net, it should be accessible.
EFJJ@comcast.net. I did not set up the original, so I don't know who does that, but I'll send it to you. Did you have a chance to look at that? So there's no discussion?
Well, My question is, what's the cost of that, carrying out that particular?
It was on the original request, approximately $535.
And who's going to pay for that?
Select board has to figure that out.
So we're requesting that the select board do that. They say they don't have the money to do that, they don't have it.
Well, there's $300 in a line item that's called budget committee communication. So maybe $200, $235-ish.
I will just say that, I mean, it's a recommendation to the board.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying, having been on the board in the past, there are times when I've been wanting to do things and wasn't opposed to it, except that we really didn't have the wherewithal to do it within the existing budget. So, I don't know the history of this or whatever, but.
Well, this particular line has never had, I don't believe, had expenses against it. And after consultation with the New Hampshire Municipal Association, the board and its current proposals, you see next week, doesn't have that line. So we've taken the $300 and put it into printing and copying. So, you know, that's where it is, because in essence, you know, these sorts of things would be a printing and copying expense.
Trying to get the value of the pension. And we're all
also working on our second person benefits.
But, I'm sorry, just so I'm clear, was there a significant increase from his salary from last year to this year?
Yes. No, he's in high.
Okay. So he was hired at a higher rate, right?
Yes.
If we're going to ask for that, then we're going to ask for the highway department as well. They're new hires. Ask for what? The market adjustment information for the new highway director. Because he was going to hire at a significantly higher rate, as was the employee for Dennis.
I'm not asking that we trouble the water district for market information. My point was, it seemed that we were sort of picking on the library as opposed to, and many of us have come here and been talking about trying to keep our employees, dealing with salaries and the competitive rates that are in the seacoast. And so I'm no sense supportive of what Dennis is having to deal with, as I am the library, as I am with some of our other departments.
I think it's different though when you're talking about a new hire, because that's where the market is at right now, and that's, you have no choice. Sarah has been there for a year or two, so
Sarah.
And so it's a significant increase to an existing position, and they said it was based on some data that they collected. That's all I'm asking for, is the data they collected.
Is there, I mean, we could have asked Dennis to say, give us the requested salaries of all the candidates who applied for your superintendent's job. We want to see if you can, how much you had to deal with. We can ask that. Well, we want it, but we can ask. And I'll make a motion that on behalf of the budget committee, that Michelle will inquire about what comparable wage information was studied for Sarah's wage increase. Will someone second?
Second.
She seconds.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
No. No, because I don't think it is sufficient enough to.
Yes. I'm going to go with you.
Say it.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
What?
Correct.
And then I just threw in the handcuffs.
just from a bookkeeping point of view, we'd be asking the Ruby.
One issue here is, what if I was on one of the reports and the U.S. asked me, why are you going to ask me, and I'm going to go fly a kite? What happens to be good?
Can I just make one quick comment? She did say when they did their presentation that they had it.
Yeah.
But yes, I agree, she couldn't say.
Just going to say, may I quote you on that, Mr. Jansen?
Well, I don't think that Trump or I will get in jail for that.
Really bring back to local politics.
And then I just put the budget reporting template in so we don't forget about it, but I know you said that you would never be able to get it done by this meeting. And then any other business to come through for the budget?
So I did contact the attorney at your recommendation, and he did indicate that that typically the select board is the mouthpiece or the communication avenue for boards and committees, for the boards and committees. There is nothing that prohibits us from doing that. And in fact, he said, so, you know, when I spoke to him, I asked him, what can the budget committee communicate? He said that really our job is to communicate the budget at the town meeting and the deliberative session. And that should be run by the budget committee and not by the select board and school board chairs. That the presentation of the budget should be by the budget committee. And that is our opportunity to convey information to voters. We have not historically done that. Historically, the chairs have presented the budget, and the budget committee has kind of silently sat by. And I want to open that up for discussion, because I think where it is the budget committee's budget that we should consider having a member of the budget committee presents it.
Actually, there was a discussion, I believe, last year or the year before about there would be a majority opinion and a minority opinion if warranted, presented at deliberative session and town meeting. Because I don't think we're going to say, all of us are thoroughly, completely in accord with this particular budget. We're going to say some of us want it this way and some of us want it that way.
Say for years I was a selectman and I was presenting it, but I was presenting it to the budget commission and lead the discussion on it, but I was also a member of the budget committee. So I never thought about withdrawal or doing it. The budget committee seemed to agree and the selectman agreed, and so I didn't worry what the authority was, but actually the budget committee did have Senate up and down, I could get up and down budget committee agreed that we wanted to do it that way. Or if we decided we wanted Vern to do it, I guess we could vote to do that.
Right. I mean, I kind of agree with that. Seems like it would be almost a waste where the
things that are in the budget as everyone else is. But perhaps what they're suggesting is the role of the chair of the school board and the chair of the board of selectmen serve the same function that NSU's got. Marie does, which is advisory. Jump in to clarify a point.
But they are members of the budget committee.
Yes.
Certainly, historically, in the last few years, the school board's representative to the budget committee has been the one who has presented the budget. It was Alan for a number of years. It was Tom when he was the representative to the budget committee. I'm now the representative to the budget committee. Obviously, it was going to be me this year, but we do actually an enormous amount of preparation. If someone else would like to take that on, it does not have to be the chair. If someone else is willing to do that, I'd certainly be happy to act as an advisor.
We can make that decision when the time comes. Whether we want to have someone from this group do it or defer to historical practice.
Just that we are from this group, right?
We are from this group, right. I mean, we are part of this group. I mean,
I think his point was is that the budget committee takes time to explain why they have prepared the budget in the way they have. And I think historically the focus has been less on the budget committee's budget and more on the select board's, the town and the school's proposed budget. So there isn't enough emphasis, and what he's saying is that's where you emphasize why you made the recommendations you did. And we haven't really had that kind of emphasis on the budgets. We've had emphasis from the town and the school, not from the budget committee.
I think in the past, I certainly remember discussing why the budget committee would or would not have agreed with a certain part of the budget committee. That's come up, and maybe we should let Josh do a better job. Because I think that's important. Myself personally as chair, I'll tell you,
volunteering?
funded the town budget.
$20,000.
This week.
Do they have a hard copy of the town hall?
Well, I won't print them in color, though.
I don't need color.
Does it cost the town money?
No. Black and white's fine.
I'll need to see that there's somebody at the town hall who can do the printing and make it available. Caroline is out for a couple of days.
How many pages have you got?
Well, there's the CIP, there's the 10-year spending projections, there's the expense budget, there's the anticipated revenue. Pages.
But those will all be copies that would have to be given to people that don't have the copies when
they come in. Next Wednesday, yes.
Like two high-speed printers and two parts.
Any other chat?
Motion to adjourn.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Those opposed, because Zach out here in the
gymnasium. Oh, that's right. Duh.